Jill Jane Clements, and I play Daisy.
My name's Rob Cleveland. I play Hoke.
But I guess the best thing I like about playing Daisy is that she is a hometown girl, and so that's very pleasant to play someone that is of Atlanta, from Atlanta, and the whole play takes, most of the play takes place here, so that's exciting.
Yeah. As far as Hoke goes, I like Hoke for a number of reasons, one of which is that personally, I think he's one of the stronger African-American male characters that you'll find on stage, and that gets some controversy from people like Spike Lee, who considers Hoke to be sort of an Uncle Tom because he's a chauffeur and he's a servant, basically. But he's so much more than that. I mean, he's a philosopher. He's a patient man. He's a very dignified man. Never does he, I think, look at himself as anything less than.
Well, I think it's, it really shows you can teach old dogs new tricks. Daisy is so set in her ways and such a product of her time. And she has blinders on, she sees only what she wants to see. And because of circumstances, she's forced to get out of her bubble, to meet someone different, to learn and grow. And that is such a powerful thing, to think, yes, we can change. We don't always have to stay in the same old rut if we'll just open up. And she has a hard time opening up, but Hoke stays with her, wrestles that hog to the ground.
Wears her down. It's kind of like a pebble making the Grand Canyon, just kind of little by little. And I think the play is so powerful because if you really think about it, I mean, how many pages is it?
39. I was just in there counting, folks.
It's a 39-page script, under 88 minutes, and you get an amazing story that spans decades in 88 minutes.
Voila, these chairs and that bench are the car. So that all has to be imagined.
Yeah.
So that's what's the fun about theater, is that it all happens just that once, just like that, you and the audience, and you go through this imagination trip, and people go out at the theater and they think they've seen all those things because mm-hmm. they've been through the whole experience, and they don't have to necessarily have an actual call.
Absolutely. It's the magic of theater, because you think about it, I mean, how silly is that to go sit in the dark and watch a bunch of grown folks on stage playing dress up? I mean, it's kind of goofy if you think about it, but there's also something incredibly magical about it. I mean, we are so hardwired for storytelling that if theater tells a good story, then everybody's taken in by the story.
I mean, like I said before, the fact we're in Atlanta, where it actually took place, just makes it more your hometown baby.
Oh, absolutely. Absolutely. I mean, the beauty of the play is, I mean, they've done it in Moscow. It's been done in New York. It's been done all over the country. But I think there is something very special about doing it in the place that when we talk about Euclid Avenue, when we talk about Highland, when we talk about the temple, that's here. The pictures are up there on our screen back there. But yeah, the temple bombing happened here. The Martin Luther King speaking at the UJA banquet, he actually spoke at a UJA banquet. So there's just an obvious, tangible connection. And the issues that the play brings up, yeah, it spans the civil rights movement, but the issues of understanding somebody who's different than you are, I mean, black, white, gay, straight, male, female,
Different
religions, different ages. Those kinds of things are never going to go away. So any kind of play that helps you look at somebody that you thought of as the other and seeing them more as more like you than not like you, I think is always going to be special.